Thank you for 700,000 subscribers, all the love and support. I never thought I'd make it this far, so thank you all very much. And as promised, every 100,000 I do a collection. And what you see behind me is my collection of hammers. I have a lifetime collection of hammers and hatchets. And what you're going to see is probably about 80% of them, because I have them tucked in nooks and crannies of my life. I have no idea where all of them are. What you see here was stowed away in 5 or 6 different places here in the basement, and now they're all together here. So now I have to actually sort them and decide which ones I want to keep out and which ones I'm probably going to store. But I'm going to go through them one at a time and take a look, and then we'll go upstate and take a look and see what I have up there. So let's go take a look. Some I made, some I bought, some I found, some I was given. I don't know exactly which ones are which, but some I do know. This is a 16-ounce S-Wing Straight Claw, which is my favorite hammer. Leather stack handle. I paint it white from time to time, as you can tell. And this is my favorite hammer. So when I see them used, I don't pay more than a couple of bucks for them. Actually, so let's assume that this is my favorite hammer. My previous favorite hammer was over here somewhere. Oh, here it is. This is my good luck hammer. Actually, I found this in the bottom of a rusty bucket at a flea market. I paid $1 for it. And when Nick Offerman and I were doing the canoe video, I used West Systems epoxy for the very first time, and I put this walnut handle on it. And this is sort of my lucky hammer for a while. And then when I started doing videos, this became my lucky hammer because I painted it white. This is just a ball peen hammer. Every time I see a ball peen hammer, I buy it if it's only a couple of dollars. I don't spend a lot of money on hammers unless I really, really, really think I need it, which is obviously I don't need anything. But ball peens are always good to have. I like skinny, light ones, and this is definitely a good candidate. This, my neighbor gave me years ago, a chrome S-Wing with the bent claw, which I don't particularly like. But I'll never say no to a good S-Wing hammer. Even if it's destroyed, I'll take it, and one day I'll fix it. So good leather stack handle. The leather's in pretty good shape. Actually, it was missing a couple pieces, and I just wrapped leather inside there to fill in the pieces that were missing. This is what's called a crate hammer. In the old days before packing tape, you had what was called crates, wooden crates, and this is a crate hammer. So this is the equivalent of like packing tape. You would open and nail and break open packages with a crate hammer, and that's what that's for. I have a lot of them. This one I'm looking at closely, I replaced one side of this. So this is one that I've had since my workshop was at my mother's house on Long Island. So this I've had for 30 years. Must have got it at a garage sale. I'll try and keep a pile of the things I referenced. This is just a big old ball peen hammer I pulled out from underneath the table. I buy these again at garage sales, so that's what that's from. This is an interesting hatchet. This is a keen cutter, but it's a... I just made this leather sheath for it. It's a keen cutter broad axe. Look at that. Flat on one side. So that's a small broad axe with a leather sheath. This, you might know, I made. I'm actually trying to get these manufactured, so I have a couple people quoting them. See if I can get these made. I'll sell them on my website if at all possible. Aluminum handle, hatchet head, just an old carpenter's axe head. Here's another one. This looks like something I might have got at a garage sale, and on a whim, either me or Dave put it on a handle. I don't know. I don't remember doing it. This is like a mica hammer or something. I don't know exactly what that material is, but I use it on the lathe because you could bang on metal with it, and it's a non-marring hammer. It's light, so it's not like a dead blow hammer. This is a Bridgeport solid axe, and it's also the inspiration for this newest video that I'm working on, which will be done soon. This is a steel handle, and I'm going to lighten it up on the milling machine, but this is just to get started. Laminated 3/8, 1/8 inch, and this axe head I got at a garage sale. This is like a real cheesy looking roofing axe. I think I got it at a garage sale. I've had this for so long. It's a weird axe. I've never used it for anything. I get these kind of cheapo hammers. People leave them here, or I get them. Friends give me their tools when they don't need them, and this is just one of those cheapo hammers I just picked up somewhere along the way. This is actually David Welder's 16-ounce hammer, and this is a great little hammer. This is the one that he and I both like the most.
This is just an old school hammer. I like the head of that, just the shape of that. This is very old. And just again, I probably found this at a garage sale or paid nothing for it. This is from a gift from, I think, Chris Burton. I hope I got your name right, brother. And CMB. So thank you for that. I've used it from time to time. This is the ham shetty made by Dave. I don't know what kind of hammer he started with, but it's got a big old knife blade attached to the handle. W for welder. This is a 12-ounce S-wing, a shorty, which I always keep in my tool bag when I go on site for a job. It's short and light, and it's fun. I got that on Amazon.com years ago. Another ball peen hammer. I like the skinny handles on the ball peens. Garage sale. This I've had since my shop was in my mother's house. John picked it up somewhere. I don't know where. It's got these rubber caps on this resin head. So you got like a resin hammer with these rubber caps. And this packing tape has been on it for 30 years. I should soak it in acetone and get that crap off. Wooden mallet, garage sale. It's got a nice heft to it. This is a really dense piece of wood, whatever it is. This mallet I got at a garage sale, and it was the inspiration for this one that you've seen me make on another video. And considering ones that I've made, this is another mallet I made, and it's made from a cutting board, an IKEA cutting board, and a piece of Brazilian hardwood, epoxied, glued together, and it still holds up. I bang on it quite a bit. Dead blow hammer. This is from Harbor Freight. It's like $7 or $8. That's a lead top. Here I have a brass hammer, Harbor Freight. I've used this quite a bit. It's really good buy. It's like $10 to $12 hammer, Harbor Freight. It's a little sledgehammer. It's like a 1 pound sledgehammer, garage sale. Great hammer for leather work. This is another soft blow hammer. This is hard rubber. Again, I use these when I'm tapping stuff in and out of the tapers on the lathe or moving stuff around. It's a great hammer. Garage sale. This somebody left here. I don't know who. It's a really old rubber mallet, and it's breaking up, but I still use it from time to time. This is, I think, a 20-ounce S-wing that I put this clip on. My controversial rigging hammer is what I like to call it, because I tie a rope to that if I'm on the top of a ladder so I don't drop it on anybody's head. And I can grab it off the side of my pocket or off my belt loop right like that, and it's right in position when I need it. Here's another resin hammer. It's like resin or polyresin or whatever. I'm sure someone's going to correct me. And again, use it when I'm tapping steel and I don't want to leave a mark. This happens to be a wooden mallet that's been in my possession from the days of living on Long Island. So this has been around for about 30 years. I don't know where it came from. Probably my dad got it somewhere. This is a hatchet. Wansei, my assistant who was just in town from Korea, he made this the other day when we were doing leather work with my Mexican kids. And this is just an S-wing hatchet. Garage sale. I must have bought this 10 years ago. I remember it was quite rusty, and I cleaned it up. It's pretty sharp. Keep it usually in the truck. This is a hammerhead. I think Dave put this handle on when we were in Kentucky. Dave, is that true? But I know Dave put this head on this handle. Another little tiny forging hammer, or whatever you might want to call it, a tack hammer on a short handle. I think I got this at a garage sale and the handle was cracked and I just shortened it just for fun. And I actually do use it. Rubber mallet, I probably got it at Home Depot. It's relatively new. This is, I think, a yard sale. Fine, sometimes I buy bunches of stuff and things like this end up in it. This is a mason hammer. I probably wouldn't have bought it unless it was with other stuff, because I probably won't use it. This is a cool hammer I got from my sister. It's like a little leather punch tooling hammer. I'm pretty sure I got it from my sister Kathleen DiResta. And I've had it now for probably about 12 or 13 years. This is cool. This is like a little ads type of hammer for chiseling. I think my dad got me this. That's exactly where this came from. My father found it somewhere and gave it to me. It's for chiseling, scooping. I never actually used it yet, but I keep it around. Once my summer assistant was here, and he wanted to put a handle on a hammerhead, and this was his experiment. If you followed along on Snapchat, you might have seen that. This is another little type of cross peen, general purpose hammer, I suppose. Maybe somebody could tell me exactly what it's called, but this is a cool little hammer. I always buy these when I see them. Again, I don't pay more than $2 or $3. This is a nylon hammer. I think I just got this at Harbor Freight, just for banging on the lathe or whatever I need. This is a cute little machinist hammer. I don't know exactly what it might have been used for, but it's cool for a little tiny soft blow, brass head, steel handle. This, me and Dave were on a job once, and we did not pack the hammer, and I actually only had to run some brad nails, so we went to the corner hardware store, and I bought this for $10 or $12 from a hardware store in Midtown, and it's something I've had for about 7 years. One of those cheapo hammers you buy, again, when you're at a construction site and everyone forgot the hammer, so you just go to the corner store and buy one. A big ball peen, got at a garage sale with no handle. I put the handle on that. I was getting into this crazy hammer making stuff when I was putting the belt clips on and stuff, and I made this off camera, but the other one I made, which is in the video, is in the back of my truck. I keep it in my truck for just general purpose. So I made this crazy one, similar to that, but it has this little pry bar on it. Another crate hammer. This one seems like it's relatively new. Somebody hit something hard with it and chipped it. I didn't do that. Another rubber mallet, relatively new, probably from a hardware store in the last 10 years. This is just a Harbor Freight body and panel hammer. I think Dave and I bought this together. This hammer head, this weird head I bought, it has a weird word here, Quick Work. I don't know if that's the brand name or the guy who made it. This weird hammer I bought, and you might have seen me use it to bang out on axe heads. I used that long nose to bang out the old handle, broken handle parts. That's what I've used it for most. I bought the head at a flea market, and I put the handle on it. About 10 years ago, I've had it now. Just another general purpose mallet I've had in my life, 20, 30 years. This I bought recently, since I've been making my videos, because I painted it white. This is like a little geology hammer. I just bought it because it looks dangerous, and I like dangerous looking things. That sexy swoop looks like something in a serial killer's toolbox. Again, another body and fender hammer, or a shoe hammer, probably more of a shoemaker's hammer. I'm not sure, maybe somebody could tell me, but you never know when you're going to need a weird shaped hammer, so I always buy all this weird stuff. It was not on a handle, I put it on a handle. Another one of those square heads. I have a lot of these hammers. I tend to find a lot of these at the flea market. Probably paid $1 or $2 for that. This is David's ball peen hammer. He specifically has this nice and shined, and the face is also shined for when he's working on copper stuff. Soft metal. So this means do not touch. That's what all that means. This is a big sledgehammer. This handle was longer. It broke, and so we just refashioned it shorter. And we did that actually recently. You could see it was kind of a hack job. Probably needed it in a hurry. Another little body and fender hammer. I don't even know where that came from. It's got the original sticker on it from the hardware store. This is a slag hammer. My buddy Junior brought this to me a couple weeks ago, just as a gift when we met. And that's for welding. Just another general purpose, old school Google search image of a hammer, and you get this. That's why I keep some of this stuff around, because you never know when I'm going to put it in a prop, use it as a prop. This is a cool lead dead blow hammer that I bought a couple weeks ago at the flea market, and I faced it with leather. I recently made a ring with this on one of the make video, on one of the make channel videos that I do. This has got a nice feel to it, real wooden handle. This is seems really old, but it's got a nice feel to it. Another simple little ball peen picked up at the flea market. This hammer I've had for about 30 years. The handle broke, and so I put it down shorter. This is just a little tack hammer. My dad must have bought this when I lived in Long Island. This is Dave, bought this at a garage sale or a yard sale. I remember we bought this together, and he grabbed it because it said NYC. And it's coming off of the handle. Oh, look, it even says Dave's name on it. This I got from when we went to the Atlanta Woodworking Show in April of 2016. In the back, there was a guy selling all kinds of discontinued tools. And this is a Williams, just like the wrench company. And you would screw faces on that, and the faces weren't there, so I'm going to make either a nylon or a brass or lead head for that. Maybe I'll do a video on that. This is actually my very favorite ball peen hammer. It stays in a special spot in the toolbox, and everybody knows not to touch it. I use it in most of my videos. And I just like the balance of it. It's partly balance, partly sentimentality, partly it's... I feel like it brings me luck, a little superstition. It's a little all of the above. This is a great mallet for chiseling. And Sean Stone, this is what I was telling you about. I finally found it. I know I owed it to you to show it to you. And here it is. And it's got a little lead thing down the middle of it. I bought this upstate New York at somebody's yard sale. I think I paid $4 for it. It's a really nice little carving mallet. Just another general purpose hammer. I don't know where it came from. Another one. This is cool. I don't know. Maybe somebody could tell me exactly what this is. This is just a crazy blacksmith hammer, I assume. I bought it to maybe put a more sexy handle on it. But it is a very heavy head. It's like a 3-pound head. Another S-wing, leather stack. The leather's a little loose, but this is just a garage sale pickup, probably $2-3. Another S-wing. I buy these in anticipating maybe restoring them. You can see the leather is worn out on this one. This is more my style with the straight claw. Seems like this is about 13-15 ounce hammer. Another chisel mallet. This is actually aluminum, solid aluminum, and I paid $3 for this. I haven't used it yet. I've had this for a while now. Solid aluminum. What do we got over here? Another really bent claw S-wing. These are really good, obviously, when you're pulling nails and you're not really hammering nails. You get a lot of leverage out of this, but the leather stack is in really good shape. This is kind of a funny looking ball peen. I bought this at a yard sale, upstate New York. This is a hide hammer with some nice weight behind it. I guess that means 3 pounds because it's pretty heavy. Chicago rawhide hammer. This is a great hammer. I got this at the flea market. You know, if you're working on car parts, you're trying to free up a manifold or something and you don't want to give it a real nice whack with steel, you use a rawhide hammer. And speaking of rawhide hammers, I got this one right here, which may have belonged to my sister, or maybe it belongs to Taylor. She uses it a lot of times when she's using punches and dies on leather. This is another rawhide hammer, which is very old. And for those of you that don't know, this is just rawhide leather wrapped in a big cylinder. And the handle's stuck in it. Keep it all tied together. And it gives you a soft dead blow. Another big dead blow soft hammer. This I've had probably for 30 years. Must have got it from my dad. But we have two different textures here, and they're both pretty beat up. This long framing hammer belongs to David Welder, I think. Dave, this is yours, right? With the tape on the handle, like we've talked about in other videos. And I believe this might be belonging to Dave as well. And here we have an S-Wing hammer that I bought at a garage sale. Brand new, but old. With the original sheath still in place. And here, I was in Kentucky a few months ago. We had to run some stakes, and we did not have electric, so I bought these to sharpen up some fairing strips to bang into the ground. So this was an emergency purchase, $30, at a Home Depot in Kentucky. It's a little blacksmithing hammer Dave bought me from Italy when he was hanging out with Jocko. You can see the name on there, Beta, with a real hickory handle. This is a sexy hammer. I got to use this in a video or two coming up when I start blacksmithing some more. Cross peen. And another little cross peen hammer. I polished this up for a video. This is just another yard sale find. I like how slim and sexy it is. It almost seems like a cartoon how dainty it is. So, here's another little tack hammer. All the hammers painted white were specifically designed to be used in videos. And I get lazy. And I have too many to choose from, so I don't always grab the one that's painted white. This is my little lathe hammer. I use this when I'm banging stuff in and out of the tapers. I got a few of them, but this is the one I've been using most often lately. Got this from Harbor Freight. I bought two of these, actually. I got one upstate, one here. Two-sided head, nylon and brass. This is a weird hammer. It's aluminum body and shank with plastic on one side and steel on the other. And I just use it for, again, dead blow or soft blow hammer on this side. I think I paid $5 for it. So I filmed that whole thing and I didn't even realize I had this in here. So let's see what we got here. A Stanley tack hammer. This is where I keep my tiny hammers. I completely forgot they were here. So there's a Stanley tack hammer. This cute little tiny hammer. I don't even remember where I got this. I've had these for years. This cool steel, probably a upholsterer's hammer because it's got this little tack remover on the bottom with a steel handle. Another tack hammer with a little nail pull at the back. Short handle. A tiny peen, really small, and you can see how small that is in my hands. That cute little hammer, it's all wired on there. I'm sure I got this at a yard sale like that, or it was in a bucket of tools I bought. And what I was actually looking for was this. That's why I went up with my toolbox. That little hammerhead, I put it on this piece of bamboo skewer, that's how small it is. This, I was in a machinist toolbox that I bought on the TV show Dirty Money. You guys remember that? This was in there. Tiny little hammerhead. It's about an inch and an eighth, inch and a quarter. Nylon hammerhead. Probably got this at like a Home Depot. This was another tack hammer that broke, and I shortened the handle. That real hack job, but something I've kept around for years. Another little tack hammer with a pull on the back. This has got red paint on it, and I vaguely remember this being around since Woodmere, which is where I grew up, so it's about 30 years now. This I bought at a yard sale. I put the handles on it. The handles are actually resin, they're not wood. But I just like that it's all cast in one piece. It did not have handles on it, and I put those handles on there. A real tiny peen. Look how big that is. That's a small brass hammer. You can see that's a cute little, like a clockmaker's hammer. And this is a soft dead blow hammer. This is copper. And this has been in my life for over 30, 35 years. This I remember from Woodmere where I grew up. So, like I say, I open drawers. I never know what's in what anymore. glad I remembered this was here. That's just what I have in New York, and there's probably about 15 more hidden in the room somewhere. Let's go take a look upstate. This first ball peen hammer got at a flea market. I love the handle. Looks like something I would have done very long ago. All this tape was on it when I bought it, so it's obviously got a crack underneath it. Just some old claw hammers. These are the kind of hammers I get for free when I gather up somebody's old junk. This one is very rusty, but this is exactly the type of hammer my dad would have had when I was a kid, so this has sentimental value. And my dad still and always does like these wooden faceted hammer handles. So as a kid, this is the hammer that I remember most, just like this. Just another S-wing with this big curve like that. It says $10 on it, but I don't think I bought it. I think someone gave it to me. This is just another sort of planishing hammer or whatever. You guys will correct me, I'm sure. This looks like a body and fender hammer. This is the same hammer I have down in the city. Got that at Harbor Freight. This is just another hokey old house burger hammer. Again, this is just like the hammer my dad would use. Faceted, classic hammer handle. Really bent nail pull, not my style. This hammer, I don't know what it's used for, but I actually use it quite a bit for blacksmithing. This crazy long tapered hammer. I put it on this long handle. I use this a lot. I got the head in a bucket of junk. S-wing that I needed on a job, so I went to Home Depot and I picked this up when I did not have a hammer with me. I get a lot of hammers like that. Just a framing hammer that broke on me years ago. I don't know who put this duct tape on there. Maybe Willie did, maybe Dave did, I don't know. Carpenter axe, I always buy these when I see them if they're cheap. This Stanley, I think, is this a Stanley? No, this is a Keen cutter. This is brand new old stock, probably from the 60s, maybe the 50s. It's absolutely brand new. I bought it from a guy that had tons of brand new old stock that was in storage. But the head is cracked. You see that crack right there? So, I mean, I wouldn't really use it with any confidence, but it's just such a beautiful hammer to see never, ever been used. And just like this, this one I think is the Stanley. Nope, it's a Plum. My dad got me this one. Also brand new, never used. Straight from a hardware store. This is a flea market find. This is a solid brass hammer. This weighs about 5 pounds, and you can see it's gotten some use. I sandblasted it. When I got it, it was all black. It's a solid brass hammer. Even the handle is solid. This is the Stanley, brand new Stanley cross peen. Never been used. I got it from that guy that had all brand new hardware stuff from the 60s. And you can see this hammer has never ever been hit against anything. It doesn't seem like it anyway. But that's actually in good shape. This is sort of a blacksmithing type of hammer. This I got, I think this is Harbor Freight, because it's obviously new. This is a leather stack, sort of a geologist hammer, or whatever you want to call it. Again, this looks like right from the kit of a serial killer, just like the blue one. And all my little hammers are here at the end. A little ball peen. A bigger ball peen, and again, this is sort of my favorite looking hammer. These tiny little hammers are cross peens. This is a brand new True Temper. This looks like old stock, another new old stock, probably out of somebody's basement. Tack hammer. I like the shape of this tack hammer head that kind of has a nice sexy curve into the handle. Oh, and this has this little cool pole. I remember buying this at the flea market about 3 weeks ago. It has that little cool sexy nail pole that's like integrated into the handle. Probably paid $3 or $4 for that. And some more ball peens. See something interesting about these. This is just a simple carpenter axe. This isn't the one I wanted to show you. Look at this one. Britain. Hand carved. Somebody did a real bad job trying to sharpen this though. Unfortunately, it's really hacked up. They did a really crummy job. But look at how sexy that is. Somebody did a really nice job carving their name into that. That inspires me. Let's take a look on the table. So I just went through some of the boxes in here real quick to see what I had lying underneath the table. And this is what I came up with. I have a lot of heavier hammers up here, obviously, because there's a little bit more room and I'm not up here as much. This looks like a railroad hammer or just like a general purpose concrete type of hammer. Let's see. Ball peen. Here's a little cross peen with a regular hammer head. That's pretty cool. Just the big old Hausberger hammer. Looks like a framing hammer. Here's sort of a soft blow mallet. I used this actually on the lathe, which was right there. This is always right on the lathe so I could bang tapers in and out. Just another general purpose hammer. This, again, on the job, needed a rubber mallet. I had to go to a Home Depot near the job, and I bought this, probably $5 or $10. This I've had for over 30 years. This is just a little wooden mallet. I use it often for chiseling. This has been in my life as far as I can remember. When I say 30 years, that basically means as far back as I could remember. This, I think I got this at a garage sale. I remember sanding the handle after I bought it. And the leather stack is in good shape. Probably $1. This kind of borders on sledgehammer, which I have a couple of to show you. This is like a John Henry hammer. Bought it just like this, probably $5 or $10 at a garage sale up here. But I just like how long that is. That's nice and sexy. That's probably for driving railroad spikes. Just another general purpose hammer. I'm sure this was given to me. I wouldn't have bought that. Another wooden mallet. At this point, I must have 5 or 6 of these. This is cool. This is another long hammer, sledge hammer kind of thing. Probably kind of more like a coal mining hammer or for hammering shale or something. This is just a short sledge hammer. That's about an 8-pound hammer. It's pretty heavy. This crazy looking hammer my dad just got me at a garage sale in Long Island. Again, that's probably for chipping rocks. Probably from a chain gang. That handle. This I bought from a yard sale. I just love the texture of it. A lot of these things I buy because I think one day I'll just hang them in the house and the house is going to look like Tchotchke's, the movie restaurant from Office Space, Tchotchke's. I buy all this stuff to hang on the wall. But this is pretty good. It hasn't left the shop yet, so I've been using it. I have about 7 or 8 of these. I can only find 2, but I know I have a lot of these. I have a couple that say Boy Scout on them. I have a couple that say Bridgeport, because they're made in Bridgeport. I have a couple of generic ones. But I can only find 2 for this video, believe it or not. Here's just another big old regular hammer. This is a cool hammer head my dad got me. I gotta put it on a handle. Another wooden mallet. This I've had for a long time. I don't know where it came from. My dad just got this as like a shoemaker's hammer. And it seems to taper from the top down so that the more you swing it, the tighter it gets. But this obviously hasn't been used in a really long time. somewhere along the way, we ended up with like 10 of these from a hardware store, me and Joey, my brother, and this is sort of the last. There's like two or three of them kicking around. I don't know why we had so many. I think we were doing a project and we needed them as a prop. Here's another S-Wing. This I just got, which is kind of cool, because it says 18-something on there. I can't remember exactly what it says, if you could figure that out. And then on this side, it says New York City something. So NYC. This definitely looks like Civil War era type casting. That's probably a model number. And then it says New York City upside down on this. Obviously, it needs a new handle. But I bought this about 3 months ago. This is the hammer that's in the video that I was with Dave. We were at the flea market. I bought this, and I was intrigued by how beat up the end of that is. Look at how many times that's been hit against something hard, probably another piece of steel. Maybe that's a factory hammer. Somebody used it for the same thing for a million years. It's pretty cool. This is a cheap hammer, but it's obviously got some use in its life. It's a drop forge, kind of like a S-Wing with a rubber handle, but it's very old. It's got a lot of texture to it. And then I have these few sledgehammers to show you. These old school. I have a lot of sledgehammers, but I'm just showing you the cool looking ones. I guess this would be called a maul. This looks like a 13-pound maul. And I bought this without a handle, and one day I was at a hardware store, and I just guessed this looked exactly like the right handle for it, and it is. Exactly the right handle for this maul. Here's another one that I bought with the handle intact. I had this since we did the TV show Dirty Money. And then this one I bought is a 14-pound maul because it looked like a cartoon sledgehammer. And it says sweet on it, or sweat, S-W-E-T-T. I don't know what that is. Maybe somebody could tell me. And there's some more initials right there, if you can see what that is. So that's what I have right here, right now. I never counted this collection. Maybe somebody can count it and put some numbers down there.
So thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed my hammer collection. Thank you for 700,000 subscribers. I have some really good videos in the not-too-distant future, so please hang with me and tell a friend. Thank you very much.